entire code of conduct, which is the rules by which other companies employ people on our behalf. So in China or Vietnam or in Portugal, if you want to make Timberland shoes in somebody else's factory or apparel, our code of conduct says we will not permit an employee to work, your employee to work more than 60, you will not allow you to have an employee of yours work more than 60 hours during a work week, in a consecutive work week. Now, if you read the codes of all our competitors, good companies, they say no more than 60 hours in any given work week, except at peak times, because it's a, you know, business is seasonal, right? And so the problem with that is it's hogwash, because we have to define our terms. So since we've said peak time and haven't said more, then if you want to work 120 hours in a factory, you know, 6 months out of the year, you just call it peak time. Now, there's a dilemma, boss, because we pay more as a result. We have to have more people in the factory. We have to flex the factory up and down harder than the other guy does. And the factory owners say to me, you're not doing the right thing. We say you have to be 16 to work in a Timberland factory anywhere in the world, not our factory, but somebody else's factory making our stuff. They say, but the law here says 15. And we say, I heard you. And if it sounds like the Imperial American from New Hampshire, you got to live with me, fellas, because I can't live with me otherwise. We've done work on this. This is what we believe is right. And so it's not an ethical challenge in the sense of should we or shouldn't we, but it plays out as like, these guys ain't easy to do business with. Or this insistence of a point of view creates tension, and it's real.